Everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing an update in my Project 10-ish pan, which is a year-long project pan that I'm doing. It is a rolling style, so when I finish something, I roll something new in. I call it 10-ish because I don't want to hold myself to 10. Sometimes I might have a few more things I want to put in. Maybe I'm just at 9, I don't have a 10 thing. So it's just around that ballpark. But I did have a very exciting month. I am filming this like a day or two early, but I'm kind of like at the point where nothing's gonna finish, or I'm not gonna hit any of the goals in the next 2 days. So I figured I might as well take this opportunity to film quick while I have the house to myself. So yeah, exciting month. I think I finished off or met my goal, I should say, for 5 products, which I'm super excited about. I have my phone here with the spreadsheet and all the juicy details. So how I like to do these updates is I like to start with the products that have been in the longest and work all the way through. So I have a few that have been in since January that I want to start with. And the first one is a lip liner. So this is the Jordana Easy Liner for lips. This is the shade Tawny. Jordana is no longer in business, but I did finish this up. So it's the type of lip liner that's retractable, so it scrolls up, but there is nothing left there, which I'm super happy about. It feels good to just finish something up. I do have the, let's see here, the lines on my piece of paper so you can see. So this is where I left off, and that was how much product I had left, and I did finish it. So I finished the lip liner off on May 5th, which feels pretty good. So another empty. And then the other item that I have from January that I finished off was my foundation. So this is the CoverFX Power Play Foundation. This is the shade N10. This is definitely a winter shade for me. It is springtime, so I'm starting to be, you know, outside a little bit more, get a little bit more color, not quite like on the beach yet, but yeah, so this was nice. I wanted to finish it up while I was still, you know, a good match with this foundation. Towards the end, I did start to mix it with a little bit of a darker foundation just to get a little bit of a better match for me, because it was looking kind of ghostly. But I am happy this is done. This has been going for a while. I've had this pre-pandemic. This was my foundation that I remember traveling with it. And then, of course, we've been home for over a year now. So I knew that this was a little bit older in my collection. I do really like this, but I'm happy that this is done so I can move on. Okay, and then the third item I have in here that has been in since January is an eyeshadow from my Anastasia Sultry palette. I am just trying to pick away at the shades in here. I think I probably will end up panning it next year, so I'm just trying to get a little bit of a head start. And the shade that I was, I still am, I should say, but the shade I put in January is Pearl, which is right here. So I do have a good amount of pan in it. I'm going to put up a side-by-side for you. Obviously, it has expanded. I'm working in kind of this corner here along this edge, but I use this as an inner corner highlight every day, and then sometimes I'll use it on my lid, kind of depending on what kind of look I want, but I definitely use it in the inner corner every day. It's kind of crumbling a little bit more now, so you can probably tell that there are definitely crumbs in there. I'm trying to keep it within the pan as much as I can, but sometimes it falls out and I'm not gonna pick it up off the floor and put it back in. I don't care that much. And that's probably not so sanitary. But yeah, that is one that I think was gonna be in for the long haul, which is okay with me. My goal is to finish it up. So yeah, my goal, you know, is moving slowly but steadily, and I'm happy with that. So this is still going to be staying in that pearl shade. So those were all of the January products that were still remaining in my project. So 2 are finished up and 1 is remaining. And then I have 1 item from February that's still in, and it's also another eyeshadow from the Sultry palette, and it is the shade Dystopian, which is this dark chocolate brown. My goal was to hit pan, and hopefully you're seeing that reflection of that shiny pan down there. So I use this as an eyeliner typically. That's how I use a lot of these darker shades in my palettes, because I don't actually use eyeliner anymore. I just use a flat liner brush. I get it wet with my setting spray, and then I dig in here and draw it on. And I love that. I've been doing it for a while, and I have so much eyeshadow, especially dark shades, that like that's a good way for me to even hit pan and try to use them. I'll never use them all up, but I did hit pan in Dystopian, which feels good to have another pan in this palette, but also just another pan in my collection. So that is the only February item that was left, and now it's rolled out, so nothing from February will continue forward. Similar to February, I have one item left from March, and that is a liquid lipstick. So this is from Bare Minerals. This is the shade Boss. My goal for this it was to use it 15 times, and I did do that. There is obviously a lot of product missing. I love this liquid lipstick. It has been well loved. It's definitely towards the end in there. And so I want to use it 15 times to kind of get another push of use out of it. This is a product, well, I guess in general, I keep track of the years that I buy makeup and then the years that they're going to expire. And I have my own set of parameters for me, liquid products. I don't want in my collection after 3 years of owning them. If I haven't finished it up, that's okay. It just needs to go. I don't feel like comfortable using it on my face. Of course, if things turn faster, noticeably the scent, the texture, if I see something on it, I'll get rid of it sooner. But this is coming up. This does have to be out of my collection by the end of this year, 2021. So I just want to use it. It still is good. So I probably will hold on to it until the end of the year and still kind of use it. I might roll it back in at some point in time to get another maybe 15 or 20 uses out of it. But it definitely is getting down there. I mean, there's not a ton of product left in here, but I did use it 15 times. I really, really enjoy this liquid lipstick. I probably will repurchase. It's my favorite formula because it's like a velvet. It's not actually matte and drying on your lips, which obviously is the best part. Okay, so that brings us to April, which was last month's update video. And I did bring in a few items then. So let's go through each of those. The first one was a bronzer. So I have this little Physicians Formula Butter Glow Face Palette. I really do like this. And I am trying to hit pan on the bronzer in here. So it is the butter bronzer. I don't know what shade. It doesn't say. I assume it's just like the original, not the lighter or the darker one. But it's right here. I do not have pan yet. But what I can tell is when I look at it sideways, there is a lot more pan showing. I don't even know if you're going to tell. Like there's more pan here, whereas I look at the blush, there's not as much silver showing around the side. So I'm definitely wearing it down, which I'm not surprised with. Bronzer for me, especially this is a pretty small pan, wears down pretty evenly. So when I hit pan, I'll probably finish it up really fast because it'll be like a big chunk of pan or it'll just be very thin, which is fine by me. I like using this bronzer right now because it has a little bit of a sheen to it. It is a little orangey if you put too much on, especially for my, fair skin. But I really have been enjoying it. It's a nice shade. And like I said, it does have a little bit of a sheen to it, which I think is pretty for the springtime. When, even though I have oily skin, I still like a little bit more of a dewy look then and, kind of the fresh face. So this is going to be staying in. I did not track how many times I've used it, unfortunately, so I don't know, but I am using it pretty much every day that I wear a full face of makeup because it's the only bronzer I'm focused on right now. So this is going to be staying in, but I don't know. I guess I don't know if I'll reach it by next month, by June's update, but I think for sure by July I'll have pan in it. All right, the next item that I rolled in April that is still going to be continuing on is another shadow from my Sultra palette. Like I said, I'm just trying to hit pan in this palette here and there. And the shade that I rolled in is the shade called Teak. And it's kind of like this bronzy brown. So this is it right here. I do have a good dip showing. I previously hit pan on Cinder, which is right here. It's a little bit lighter of a bronze, but they are pretty similar at the end of the day. I feel like I can use them interchangeably. So my goal is to hit pan on Teak. I did not reach that this month, but I think next month I probably could. So it is, definitely getting deep in there. And now that I've hit pan on Cinder recently, I know kind of the depth. So this one I'm using in the outer third of my eye looks just to add a little bit more of like a depth there. I also really like it on my lower lash line. So this is one that I feel like I can incorporate quite a bit into my looks. It's not as difficult as maybe like an orange or some crazy color. It's a pretty neutral that it's not that hard. So I hope to have pan by next month on this one if I put a little bit more effort into it. I might try it all over the lid. It is a little bit darker than Cinder. I did like Cinder all over the lid, so I don't know if this is gonna be too dark for me, but I think it's worth giving a shot. Maybe I could even layer some like pearl over it to lighten it up and get use out of both of my Project Pan eyeshadows in here. But yeah, Teak is going to be staying in. It's been in for 1 month now. Last month, I rolled in another eyeshadow into my project. I am working on all of the like cream, bone type eyeshadows in my collection that I can use in the same manner. I do set my eyeshadow primer every day to help with kind of the discoloration, but also to have that primer set down a little bit more to help with blending. So in April, I rolled in my e.l.f. Bite Size Quad. This is the cream and sugar variety, I guess. And so I pulled in this first shade. It doesn't have a name, but I didn't have Pan last time, but I do now, which is exciting. So my goal is just to go through and hit Pan on all of these, and then I'm going to circle back to actually finishing them up. So I was able to hit Pan on this one. Let's see. I did track how many uses. It took me 15 uses to hit Pan on this, and I do use, you know, kind of a significant amount. I definitely use more of a cream shade than I would like a crease shade, just because I'm covering more of my eyelid. So 15 uses for me to hit Pan on this one. And I hit Pan actually on May 1st, which is very like kind of exciting to start a fresh new month with Pan. So yeah, I did achieve my goal on this one. So it is rolling out, and I'll be rolling in another cream eyeshadow in its place because I still have some I don't have Pan in yet. All right, I've got two more products from April that I'm still going to be working on. This one is a blush. So this is a ColourPop blush, and it's the Fresh and Peachy. So it is like a matte blush. It's a really beautiful peach shade. I'm really, really enjoying it. I feel like peach in the springtime is just really fitting. I'm always drawn to peaches. So my goal is to use this 30 times and then roll it out. That's what I would like to do with most of my blushes and like highlights and stuff this year, is just to get uses on them so that I know I'm using them all. I can, you know, give them dedicated time and attention, I guess. So this one, again, 30 use goal. I used this 9 times since my last update. So I still have 21 uses left to go before I can roll this one out, but that is fine by me. Like I said, I am enjoying using this, but I don't use it every day. It kind of depends on the eye look that I'm going with. So if I'm wearing something that I think a more like rosy blush would complement, I'm actually reaching for the blush in this little palette since it's, you know, in my makeup basket anyway. So this is the other blush I've been using, but I'm not panning it at this time. I don't have any goals on it. So yeah, this one is going to stay in, and I have 21 more uses until it rolls out. All right, and then also in April, I brought in another lip product. So this is a lipstick from the Ulta Beauty brand, and it's called the Velvet Matte Lip Crayon. I do have it on right now. I snuck in another use here before I started filming. These are very comfortable, and they are not discontinued yet. I feel like Ulta Beauty, like, brings things, discontinues them really fast, but these are still out there. I will link to them down below, but I definitely myself am interested in getting another one. It is a, it's a matte, but it kind of feels like a cream, you know? So anyway, this is the shade Terrestrial, which is kind of like a peachy nude. It is on my lips today, so you can kind of see how it looks on. My goal with this is to use it 25 times. Similar to my blushes, I just kind of want to rotate through. I do have some lipsticks that I really need to focus on this year because similar to my Bare Minerals liquid lipstick, they will be expiring per my standards this year. They're all darker shades that I feel like in the fall and winter I'll be able to use more naturally, but I'm just not drawn to them right now. So this is the one that I'm working on. It is like in this crayon, you know, format here. And I did mark it on my sheet just because I'm curious to see, you know, how much is used up by the uses. So I used this 14 times, this between last update and now. And I did mark it on my sheet here. So this is the Ulta Terrestrial. And I started, you know, at this line, and then this is after 14 uses here. So a decent amount of progress. I actually was a little bit surprised by that. It is a pretty soft formula, though, and it is in the crayon instead of like a traditional bullet lipstick, you know, like the surface area that you apply is a lot smaller. So I think that's why you can see a bigger jump than like, you know, a more thick bullet of a lipstick. But I did use this 14 times, so I have 11 more uses until I can roll it out, but it's not been anything that, you know, I'm really pushing myself to use or struggling to use. This is something that is coming very naturally. I enjoy how it looks, so it's easy for me to go through, but I am curious to see how far I get on my little cheat sheet here with the markings after 25 uses. because then I might be able to estimate like how many uses till I actually finish it all up, which could be a fun thing to try, but maybe like later in the year. Okay, so those were all of the updates of what was in my project pan. I did reach my goal on 5 of the items, so I had 5 spots to fill if I wanted, and I did pick 5 new items that I would like to work on. So let's talk about what my new products and goals are. First things first, to replace the like matte white bone eyeshadow that I was working on, because I just immediately after I hit pan on this already picked my next one out because I use it each time I do my makeup. So I already have been working on this eyeshadow and I have it in a little Z palette, but it does come from my ColourPop Bare Necessities eyeshadow palette. And this is the shade Full Exposé. So it is like a matte, you know, white cream shade. There's really not much of a dip. There's definitely like a disturbance. You can tell where I put my brush, but there's not a dip in it yet. So I have been using this one, and I have been using this, let's see here. I've used it 7 times so far, and I actually have never tracked how long it takes me to hit pan in a ColourPop eyeshadow. I have hit pan in one before, but I didn't track it. So I am curious to see how long this is gonna take me. If my memory serves me right, the last time I used one, I think it took me like a good 6 weeks or so to like really get down in there. So we'll see, you know, usage wise, how many uses it ends up being, but this is gonna be the eyeshadow that I roll in. All right, the next product that I'm rolling in is my setting spray. This is the only setting spray I have at the moment. It is the NYX Bare With Me Prime Set and Refresh setting spray, or multitasking spray, they say. There is actually a little bit of the Milani setting spray in here. I had a little bit left in a travel bottle that I just dumped in here. But yeah, this is the only spray I have. It's not my favorite. I actually do prefer the Milani one over this. So I'd like to finish this up. I did mark it on the packaging. So we're starting right here, basically at the top of the barcode label. And I do use this in a couple of ways. I do set my face with it. You know, when I'm done with all of my powder products, I set my face down. And I also put a spritz of this on the back of my hand each day that I wear eyeliner. Like I was talking about earlier with that dark brown shade, I use a flatliner brush. I put like half a spray on the back of my hand, get my brush wet, and then go into the black or brown eyeshadow that I'm going to be using to line my eyes. So I do use it in 2 different ways, but it's not like I'm overusing it. I do think this is going to take me a couple of months to finish up, to be honest. It's not like something that I just fly through. But yeah, you know, I figured this was an easy enough product to put in because it's kind of one of those things that I really only feel like I need one at a time. Like, I don't need to have multiple setting sprays. It's just one till completion and then use it up and get a new one. So yeah, that is going to be rolling in for us. I do have another eyeshadow that I would like to work on. It is not in the Sultry palette. it's actually coming from a little quad that I put together of ABH shadows. So you can get 4 eyeshadows of your choosing and the little case here that has, you know, Anastasia on it. It's a magnetic case. It's on deal at both Sephora and Ulta. You do get kind of like a discount with it. So I purchased these last spring VIB sale, so 2020, because you get the discount and then, you know, the 15% or whatever on top of it, which was a really great deal to be able to pick out some shades. So these are definitely like very rosy. It does kind of give me Charlotte Tilbury quad vibes, you know, the Pillow Talk quad. So the shade that I'm going to be working on is this sparkly one here. This is Pink Champagne, which used to be talked about all the time, I feel like. I do kind of have a divot in there, but I don't know if that's natural or not. So when I got my eyeshadows, the pink, both of these two were a little bit crumbled, so I immediately had to repress them. So it definitely changed the formula a little bit. And I think, you know, just with me hand repressing them, there could have already been kind of a weird dip in there. But this is the shade that I would like to hit pan on. I do think it'll take me a few months, but it is just this gorgeous, I don't know, it's just like a pinky bronze. Like, it looks way more intense on my finger there. But when you have it on, there, it's kind of blended in a little bit. It's just catching the light there. It's a perfect lid shade for me. I really, really like wearing this with, because of that like warmth, I can go more brown, I can go more rosy. It's just one of my favorite eyeshadows, to be honest, and it's not like over the top glittery, even though it looks that way in the packaging. So my goal is going to be to hit pan on it. I do expect it to be in for a couple of months before I do that, because these are like full size eyeshadows. Like they're pretty deep, you know, like it's different than the eyeshadow palette eyeshadows. Because these are 1.7 grams here, and then the eyeshadows in here are 0.83 grams. So there is definitely a size discrepancy. So I'm going to be curious to see how long this lasts me. I definitely have used this before. I don't know how many times, but I probably will start tracking now, you know, how many times since I rolled it in did I use it to hit pan, and you know, we'll just know that it's more than that number in the end. So that's going to be a goal of mine. I kind of just want a nice go-to lid shade that I don't really have to think about. And I figured this was a good one. I also don't have pan in any of these eyeshadows. And I'm kind of like low-key on this mission to hit pan in every palette, because I saw that hashtag on Instagram and I was like, ooh, I kind of want to do that, but like unofficially. So that is one that I decided I would, you know, kind of work on. All right. And then the next item I'm rolling in is a highlighter. So this is new to me. This is ColourPop's Lunch Money Highlighter, which I feel like is a cult classic. I heard about Lunch Money years ago, you know, when these first launched, and I finally got my hands on one. I've never really tried a ColourPop Super Shock eyeshadow or cheek product until like I got some this year, actually. So I was thinking, was it last year or this year? But it was still in 2021. So this is new to me. I have used it a few times. I do really like it. It is a really nice highlighter. Right down here. There we go. I really enjoy it. I enjoy using it, like tapping on with my fingers. I have a stipple brush that I like to use with it. But I would love to know, how is your favorite way to use it? My goal for this is going to be to use it 30 times. Sorry, that was my laundry. I would like to use this 30 times. Again, like I said, just rotating through. It is new to me, so I don't feel the pressure to like use it up immediately. You know, I still have definitely a couple years of this in my collection before I feel like it needs to be rolled out. But I do think that this is something, you know, I want to use now because of the light kind of golden champagne shade. And I don't know, it's new to me, so it's exciting. So I want to use it. I'm not hate panning it. I'm actually very excited about most things that I'm panning right now. I don't really hate pan anymore. Okay, I have one last item I'm going to be rolling in. I'm rolling in another lip liner. This is the NYX Natural Lip Liner. It's a lip pencil that you sharpen. I worked on this last year, didn't finish it up, but definitely made good headway. So the swatch of it is right here. It is very neutral in color. It's going to be easy to use. I just need to get in the habit of using it. And because I just finished up that Tawny Jordana lip liner, it's kind of in my habit now because I've been working on that for months. So I did mark it on my paper, and I'm really just saying this for my own memory, but I marked it starting at the black, so I have the little pink tip off there, because I know that it's not actually going to go all the way down to the bottom. It'll end when I can't sharpen it anymore. But this is where I'm starting, way up here. So I do have quite a bit of progress to go when you look at it on the sheet of paper, but when you look at it here, you're like, oh yeah, that's pretty short already. So we'll see. I definitely, again, think this is going to be in for a few months. So all of that to say, that was a lot of talking. I rolled out 5 things. I'm rolling in 5 new things, and I'm just excited. I'm happy with the progress I've made. I'm happy with the products that I'm choosing. So, you know, all in all, a good spot. So that's going to be it for me. I've been talking for way too long at this point. I do appreciate you taking some time out of your day to hang out and spend some time talking about makeup with me. And yeah, that's going to do it for me. Let me know what you're panning down below. I'd love to check it out either on Instagram or on YouTube. So thank you, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.